Hello guys, in this video, I'm going to share with you how I migrated here in the UK as a radiographer, or in the Philippines, it's called Radiologic Technologist. So sit back and watch the entire video. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Ryan. I'm a BS Radiologic Technology graduate in Lorma Colleges back in 2008. I started working as a CT scan radiographer in St. Luke's Medical Center, Bonifacio Global City, back in 2009, and worked there for 5 years. After that, I became a CT scan application specialist of Toshiba Medical System, and worked there again for 2 years. And soon after that, I decided to apply overseas, you know, just to look for greener pasture. Just that's what they said. So luckily, I landed a job in Kingdom Saudi Arabia. From there, I use it as a stepping stone to migrate here in the UK. Now, I'm going to share with you the things that I did and the documents that I submitted before applying here in the UK as a CT scan radiographer or as a radiographer. But before that, just to let you know, I did all these things on my own without going to agencies, meaning this is based on my personal experience. So if you guys have a different route, please comment down below so that our fellow radiographer will have some, or we'll have other options also. Alright, so first requirement, you need to be HCPC registered. What is HCPC? HCPC is a Health and Care Profession Council, meaning they're the one giving license so that you can work and apply here in the UK. It is like PRC in the Philippines and Saudi Council in Saudi Arabia. Alright, so I will put a link in the description below if you want to apply as a radiographer here in the UK. Now, if you're applying outside the UK as a radiographer, you need to download the international application form. So in that application form, there are 7 sections. So I will discuss to you those 7 sections and the documents you need to provide in each section. But before that, if you are new to my channel, please consider to click that subscribe button below and hit that notification bell so that every time I upload a new video, you will be the first to be notified. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you. Alright, so let's go through those 7 sections of the HCPC application form. So let's begin with the section 1. Section 1 is all about your personal details. Example, your name, your date of birth, your address and all that. So the documents needed on that section is your valid passport and your proof of billing under your name. So those two, you need to photocopy it and then it should be notarized. Alright, next section is the section 2, which is your qualification in relevant profession or your educational background. So there are 4 documents that you need to provide on that section. First is your transcript of record. Second is your college diploma. Third is your certificate during your internship. And fourth is the copy of your course syllabus. All right, and on the 3rd section, it will be your professional experience. So there are 4 documents that you need to submit on that section again. So first is your certificate of employment or your COE. Next is your job description. Third is your reference letter. 4th document, it will be your trainings and seminars certificate. Alright, so on the 4th section, it will be your professional registration and membership. So if you're working in the Philippines or you're registered in the Philippines, it will be your PRC. So 1st document will be your PRC, valid PRC ID. 2nd will be your PRC board rating. 3rd will be your PRC board certificate. 4th will be your PRC certificate of good standing. So you need all those from PRC. And if you're working in Saudi, you need to submit your certificate of registration from Saudi Council and your Saudi Council ID. So those are the things that I submit on that section. All right, so in your section 5, it will be your English language proficiency. So HCPC required IELTS or UKVI IELTS to be submitted on that section. All right, so section 6 will be paying your scrutiny fee. So HCPC will email you a link when they start processing your document so that you can pay the processing fee. And on the last section, which is your section 7 or your declaration, so there are questions that you need to answer in there regarding your character and your health. So after you answer all those questions, you need to write your name and your signature and the date when you signed that declaration form. After you completed that application form and completed all your documents, you can now submit it and post it by mail on the address provided on that application form. So it is on the right upper corner of the application form, the address of HCPC. After that, just wait for HCPC to email you back if all your documents are accepted. Good luck. Almost three months to be registered in HCPC. So I submitted all the documents first week of May 2018 and received an email from HCPC last week of July 2018 that I already got registered. And as soon as I got registered from HCPC, I immediately applied online for a job here in the UK. So it took me almost 2 months. Applying for a job here in the UK. So it was very frustrating because a lot of my applications was rejected. A lot of them withdrew my application because they required me to come here in the UK to personally interview me, and I cannot afford to come here in the UK during that time because I was working also in Saudi. So I requested for a Skype interview, but a lot of them refuses. Until one day, one of the NHS trusts here in London, they agreed for a Skype interview. So after that interview, they emailed me asking me if I want to accept the job because I passed the interview. So yeah, I immediately answered yes, and by God's grace, I am now here in the UK. So now I will discuss to you the work visa processing. All right, so to begin processing your work visa coming here in the UK, you need to go to www.gov.uk, and from there you need to choose general work visa tier 2, and it will ask you which country you are going to process your visa. So in my case, I choose Saudi Arabia, and from there it will again ask you which visa center you are going to submit all your documents. So I choose vfsglobal.co.uk to submit all my documents. So it is my application center that I choose during that time. For the documents that I submit, the first document that VFS Global required me to submit is my certificate of sponsorship from my employer, and then job offer. Third will be my police clearance from Saudi Arabia. Fourth will be the UKVI IELTS, and then fifth will be my valid passport. So those are the documents that they ask, aside from visa fee and the IHS fee. So for the IHS fee, you need to pay that so that you can access the health benefits here in the UK while you work. And then as soon as I submitted all the documents that VFS Global City asked me to submit and pay for the visa fee and the IHS fee, they asked me to wait for 3 weeks. And then it was January, first week of January 2019. When I received a call from VFS that my visa is already available for pickup. So I went there to pick up my passport and the visa, my work visa coming here in the UK. So as soon as I received my visa, I immediately booked for a flight here in the UK, and by God's grace, January 19, I arrived here in the UK, 2019. So now, I'm already working here in the UK for almost 2 years now, guys. So that is my radiographer journey here in the UK. Thank you for watching. Hope I inspire a lot of you guys, to especially my radiographer colleagues, to apply here in the UK also. So thank you very much for watching.